After half a century in showbiz, Elton John's life story gets a glittering go-round in Rocketman. I'll review Rocketman, and we'll take a musical voyage through Elton's big screen career. Plus, I'll review four other new films, including Alec Baldwin as John DeLorean, and the story of a woman who has just too many birds. All that on our podcast, Movies for the Rest of Us. When Elton John made his movie debut as the pinball wizard in Tommy, there were those who felt he just might have a future on the big screen. Of course, Elton had other ideas. Still, for nearly 50 years, he's been providing us with movie memories through his music and the occasional cameo. Here are 19 classic Elton John movie moments.
Cast a pebble on the water. Watch the ripples gently spreading. Tiny daughter of the camel. We were meant to be together.
You know something, people? You're going to be remembered the rest of your lives for the day you got held up and kidnapped.
Lately, I've been thinking. How much I miss my lady. Now marinas in a
to make you love me. What do I gotta do to make you care? What do I gotta do when lightning strikes me?
Yesterday, you came to lift me up, as light as straw and brittle as a bird. Today, I weigh less than a shadow on the wall, just one more whisper.
So goodbye.
Wednesday,
isn't
that supposed to be Saturday?
What day is it today?
Wednesday.
Exactly.
Do you like the Elton John song Rocketman?
I don't like.
Well, I only bring it up because it's you. You're the Rocketman.
How your heart nearly burst from the sheer rapture of last year's enthralling Bohemian Rhapsody? Well, prepare to have your heart skip some beats and then get broken by the equally breathtaking Rocketman, a powerful and poundingly musical biography of Elton John. Taron Egerton brings an ingenious mix of cockiness and vulnerability to the main role, and if his singing isn't quite up to Sir Elton's, his sensitive performances elicit the dramatic subtext of each one.
Don't know. Haven't decided yet. But whatever it is, you're not invited.
Were Elton John's parents really as hideous as portrayed here? Did he really take Bernie Taupin's lyrics, slap them on a piano, and simply let the melody of Daniel pour out? Maybe not. But this is the movies, and movies don't get much better than Rocket Man.
What do you wear to your mother's funeral?
Mom would have wanted me to wear black.
Well, Mom's dead.
In Mouthpiece, two actresses share the role of Cassandra, a 30-year-old woman who has just lost her mother, playing two sides of her psyche, which are often at odds with each other. It's a terrific conceit that starts out a little gimmicky, but by the end, the performances of Amy Nussbacken and Nora Savada become seamless. Director Patricia Rosma masterfully spins a web of plausibility around what should be an utterly implausible premise.
Just tell the truth.
Allow me to introduce the DeLorean motor car.
Framing John DeLorean is a new documentary based on the rise and fall of that legendary 1980s car mogul, and it takes the unusual approach of having Alec Baldwin portray DeLorean in pivotal scenes.
I'm going to try to be DeLorean.
Baldwin is always fun to watch, but the directors waste too much time speaking with him in his makeup chair. The fact soon becomes clear that Baldwin doesn't know much more about DeLorean than we do.
When does DeLorean get to a point where he could have turned back?
Hi. I hear you.
Documentary maker Richard Moran spent years filming the twisting, tortured story of a New York State woman who collected ducks, chickens, and turkeys the way other hoarders collect newspapers.
Nearly 100 birds were living in filthy conditions.
Kathy has a very unruly lawyer.
It's going to be a battle royal.
Yes.
For the Birds starts out as a sad portrait of obsession, but don't fly the coop too soon. There's an unexpectedly upbeat ending. With a title like The Fall of the American Empire, you'd expect writer-director Denis Arcand's drama to be sweeping in scope. Instead, it's the finely focused tale of a meek deliveryman who stumbles upon millions of dollars following a botched robbery. Arcand, who's Canadian, seems to want to say a lot about the chasm between the rich and the poor and about the redistribution of wealth. But his message gets tangled in a loopy plot in which everyone seems to make all the wrong choices at all the wrong times.
While the others kids were rocking around the clock.